Rifles put holes through people. Shotguns at the right range with the right load will physically remove a chunk of shit off your opponent and throw that shit on the floor.
Morning, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Today we're talking about shotguns. A lot of shotguns.
Some big, some small, and we've got Corey. So welcome, Corey, to the channel and our shop. He started with us last week. So,
Andy, take it away.
Corey is our new hire. His call sign is going to be Chief Mustache.
Damn. I don't even have a call sign.
Today we're going to talk about shotguns. I got to get the thumb down there.
That's what they do.
I did a little bit of research. It's probably my favorite weapon system. I believe it is the oldest weapon system probably by mankind. As soon as they figured out they could put black powder in a pipe and put rocks in it or glass in it and shoot it at another person. I'm pretty sure this is over 1,000 years old on this
angry
design.
Tube.
Yeah, it's an angry tube at the end of the day. We've got a couple of different models here that we brought out. This is my Benelli 1301.
Oh, God damn it.
who?
Beretta 1301. This is a Remington 870 that's been to VanComp with a bunch of mods. This is a Mossberg 590A1 in a short barrel shotgun. We'll talk about that in a minute. This is a Mossberg 590 AOW. This is not a Shockwave. This is a NFA item, and I'll explain the difference here in just a second. The ATF regulates shotguns to be an 18-inch barrel with a stock. To be regulated as a short barrel shotgun, it's a $200 tax stamp. This is a 14-inch barrel. They can be shorter, and then it has a stock on it. An AOW, and this is the difference, an AOW does not have a stock. This is a $5 tax stamp versus a $200 tax stamp. It is not recommended that you put a stock on this. It's basically not legal. You would make it from an AOW into an SBS, and these are both taxable items. What makes this different than that dumb shit Shockwave that everybody's selling right now is the overall length. This is under 27 inches. Shockwave is over 27. You should not make it shorter to be legal. You can have a front grip on an AOW. You should not have a front grip on a Shockwave. Again, this is a prohibited feature. So, AOW, under 18-inch barrel, front grip, back grip, short barrel shotguns. I could run a grip on it if I want. I just don't think it's worthwhile. 14-inch and a stock, 18-inch and a stock. I could put a pistol grip on this and an 18. Doesn't really matter. 18-inch and a stock also. So, shotgun, short barrel shotgun, AOW.
So what would be a AOW for a definition?
Any other weapon, which means it falls into a definition from the ATF. There are AOW rifles also.
It's basically the ATF going,
yeah, they really don't know what it is. So it's an other.
They don't know much of anything.
Yeah, any other weapon, because it doesn't fit inside this category, which is the same as the Shockwaves, I think, are sold as.
Is firearms.
Firearms, right. So.
Is there anybody in Bonner's Ferry that can help us with shotgun mods?
I think there might be. Yeah. We're going to shoot a couple of these here in just a second. I want to talk about flight control. Shotgun shell, basically primer, powder, a wad, and then the projectile. 12 gauges, we'll do a different video on gauges and how that all works and why this is called 12 gauge versus 10 gauge versus 20 gauge. It would take too long to explain all of that, but it's got to do with payload. 12 gauges typically shoot 8, 9, 10 pellets. There's some new product called this Mini Buck. So it's 12 gauge also, it's just quite a bit shorter. So in the right application, you can hold almost double the count. So if this is shooting number 4 buck, this will have probably 41 pellets. I think these are 15 pellets, and they're not any more lethal or less lethal. There's just less of them, if that makes sense. So what the Mini Buck gives you is less recoil because you're pushing less payload, and it's going to be more controllable. And in these little guns, I think these hold like 9 or 10 rounds, just quite a bit. Not all guns can shoot this. Because they're short enough that they'll get into the gun and then lock up in a vertical position and cause some problems.
Predictions on these shotguns, Corey? One's going to be more hurdy than the other?
This bad boy right here. I'm not excited to shoot that.
I think if we take the 3-inch Magnum shells and don't put them in there, I think we'll be okay.
If you want to protect yourself, get a double barrel shotgun. Have the shells, a 12-gauge shotgun, And I promise you, as I told my wife, we live in an area that's wooded and somewhat secluded. I said, Jill, if there's ever a problem, just walk out on the balcony here, or walk out, put that double barrel shotgun and fire two blasts outside the house. I promise you, who's ever coming in is not going to, you don't need an AR-15. It's harder to aim, it's harder to use, and in fact, you don't need 30 rounds to protect yourself. Buy a shotgun. Buy a shotgun.
Biden also said he learned gun safety from his father.
Doesn't matter to me.
We go big to small.
Yeah, let's go.
Cool.
All right, well, I predict the cardboard's not going to survive. Again, the Beretta 1301, we did another video on it. Still an amazing shotgun, super smooth. And honestly, patterning with the shotgun with this ammo, this is just a mistake. I don't think it was anything super crazy, but that's devastating. I would not, oh, pocket round. Pretty cool.
We're gonna talk about flight control wads versus a traditional wad. So, Federal came out with this product for law enforcement, I'm gonna say probably 10 years ago. It was restricted. I got a bunch of it through State Patrol and Corrections. So, if you look at the photo here on the wad, a traditional shotgun wad is basically a plastic cup. You got the payload inside of it, and as it comes out, the pedals open up, and then the shot just kind of scatters. What Federal figured out, somebody there smarter than us put together, they basically kept the wad together, put the payload inside, and then installed an air brake. So there's a small air brake on the front and then on the back. So everything comes out in a solid line. We'll set up a target here and you can see the difference on flight control versus regular buck. So let's move.
All right, one shot, Federal flight control.
That was a fucking miss.
Where'd it go?
Over the top.
I haven't sighted in my arms.
Let's try that again. Okay.
Shoot out of yours.
I will mention that with flight control, you need to zero your shotgun.
Yep.
Which John just found out. two and three quarter, double op buck, buffered, which we'll talk about in a minute, but non-flight control, so. Actually, pounding pretty good. So the industry standard on buck shot, 4 buck, 5 buck, whatever you're shooting, is 1 inch per yard. So double op buck at 5 yards would be 5 inches. 15 yards would be 15 inches. Clint Smith does a really good video, which I'll show you in there, where he's got this string and it kind of explains how that works. Flight control is a game changer. Again, that's a 30 yard target and there's at least, how many hits are on that, 5 or 6? So that should actually be a 30 inch circle and it's down to about 6. It looks like I pulled a little to the left. So flight control buckshot will bring the pattern in exponentially tighter. Van Comp has a system in his shotguns, Hans Vang. He's a shotgun guy. He's been doing this for longer than I've probably been alive, but he's got a system where he lengthens the forcing cone and it increases the accuracy because it's not as harsh on the wad as it goes down the barrel. So it tends to smooth, it's a smoother transition from the starting diameter to the finishing diameter, which is referred to as the choking area, which again, that's probably a subject for different video. But a couple things that we learned a few minutes ago is that the flight control product is actually not labeled. So once you take it out of the box and then dump it on the table with this mixed bag of potpourri, you don't know what's flight control or what's not flight control.
Not flight control.
Flight control buckshot at about 5 yards. So I'm going to mention Mossberg 590. This is a company in Texas that makes this mini adapter. Mossberg is now offering the 590 S series, which will run the shorts or the mediums or the longs. So you have to have this in these 590s to run these shorts. But I think it holds like 9 or 10. It's ridiculous. Couple like you mean it.
There. Interesting. Oh, I was just watching it go in.
There's a bag right there. So I will say, while John's loading that, these mini bucks, incredibly controllable. It's still 15 pellets of number 4 buckshot. Man, this is, it's controllable, and there's a lot of rounds. This is plenty of gun for...
I'm really excited to shoot it. We're gonna see how it does. I've shot this with, you know, this normal double up buck, the 2 3/4 inch, and it was not fun. So, see what it does. Oh, there was nothing.
Yep.
Got him. This is pretty cool.
Oh shit.
That was actually awesome.
Actually, while we're at it, I wanted to try something. So 2 3/4 minis. Let's see if this works, which I don't know if it's gonna. Let's just try one. You ready? And
so that's what happens when you throw minis in a regular shotgun.
It's no good.
Oh my god!
So did it.
Well, it actually fed. It just didn't. It didn't have enough gas.
Yeah.
It didn't adjust. Got no gas in it.
So. Okay. Pump it hard. Oh, it's no good.
No good.
No good.
Here, let's see.
Oh, you're way jammed up.
I think you pulled it
too. Oh, hard. No, you put a regular size shell in it.
Oh, you've got the mini.
So I will mention on a older model, if you run this, you can't run a full size at this point. Mossberg's 590S has that fixed. It will run shorts, 2 3/4 and threes. It'll run whatever you want. Corey just found out that you can't run 2 3/4 with the adapter in this thing. So I hope we caught that fail on video.
The days are over. And life is life.
What was that? Pulled it to the right. I gotta warm up. Andy and I have a bet. We have a coffee bet.
What do you want to do? Tell me what you want.
What do you want to do?
All right, 3 rounds.
Okay.
Empty gun.
Okay.
From a different pocket than you normally practice from. So not your back left pocket.
Well, how about I don't practice this? So any pocket?
Yeah.
Okay.
3 rounds, empty gun.
So 3 rounds, empty gun.
Yeah.
What pocket are you gonna do?
Jacket.
I'll do it left-handed.
Oh, I'm so gonna lose the gun.
All right, I'll give you a.
Where are we starting from?
On war crimes.
So, I ready? I ready or shoulders?
Preference, whatever you want. All right, you gentlemen ready?
Oh, hold on.
Oh. What are we doing?
Okay, all right.
On your mark, get set, war crime.
Did you get me?
Yeah.
Barely.
I waited for a second, then I saw your hand still had the other round. I was like, oh shit!
I didn't think you'd see that. I tried to pull a sneak.
He's like, I definitely had three. This Andy's sneaky counter in the corner.
Gov, German government protests against the use of shotguns by American Army. In World War I, but it's fine.
I thought it was a war crime.
So did I.
Looks like we're back, baby.
I was always told.
Evidently, shotguns are not a war crime.
The government lied to me.
What?
No way.
Well, thanks for joining us at the range. I don't know about you guys, but there was a lot of questions I had personally going into this on SBSs versus AOWs, and basically what I've learned is it's still very gray and I'm really not sure.
It doesn't make a whole lot of sense.
I think we can agree that the ATF is poop and it should be abolished, but this is part of that. Thanks for tuning into our channels and stuff, you guys. I appreciate that. Like, subscribe, share. I do want to mention we got a bunch of new merch at the location, so new beanies here. New heavy duty hoodies in ivory and in green, available at all of our locations and stuff. So thanks for tuning in.
Have a good one, guys.